Australia is a vast continent with varied landscapes both above and below surface. Within those landscapes, there are ancient rocks preserved, and if we're lucky, those rocks may contain mineral deposits. Looking deep into the subsurface lets us understand some critical information about how South Australia was formed, when it was formed, and how it's changed over time. To do this, we use different techniques across different scales, from regional surveys across vast areas to small-scale surveys, even down to looking at a grain or a mineral within an individual rock. We combine this information to make maps and models which helps us understand what the geology is below the surface, how these features are linked, and where we might find the next area of mineralisation. We connect rock properties that extend below the surface across horizons or layers, and we do this using different techniques such as geophysics, geochemistry, and also geochronology. And this helps us build a picture of what the geology is below the surface. We can use sophisticated methods that help us link time with rock forming processes, including mineralization. This is important because certain geological periods are more prospective for mineralization than others, and this can help us identify and target those opportunities. When we bring all this information together, it helps inform us to make decisions about where the next area to explore might be. However, this journey is rarely linear. After millennia of geological activity, some areas may sit as a snapshot in time, whereas others may have been remobilized, carrying with them some of the minerals that have formed those mineral deposits. So, we look for clues in the geology, the geophysics, geochemistry and geochronology that can help lead us to more tenable areas. By combining different data sets together, such as magnetotellurics, gravity, petrophysics, geochemistry, geochronology, as well as various landscape mapping, we can build a picture of how the Earth formed, what it looks like below the surface, and where mineral deposits may occur.